Dear student, I am teacher Mukesh Kumar. I'll teach you business communication chapter 1, introduction to business communication definition. Before starting definition, first I would like to tell you, we will cover all the topic. Letter writing, covering letters, memos, circular letters, complaint letters, CV writing, and all sorts of things. Inshallah, I'll cover all these things in my lecture. First, start with the definition of business communication. The word communication has originated from the Latin word communis or communicare, which means to share, impart, participate, exchange, transfer, to make common. It means the sharing of ideas in common. We can say sharing of ideas in common. Ideas are information that we can share with one another in an organization, outside the world, person to person communication that we call interpersonal communication. The purpose of communication is, as I have written, deciding whether language is informal, less formal, formal, it's not important. It must be clear, concrete, understandable. Now, according to Alan Lewis, in my point of view, this is the complete definition of business communication. Communication is the sum of all things. One person does when he wants to create understanding in the minds of other. It involves systematic and continuous process of telling, listening, and understanding. Now again, I am repeating, telling, listening, and understanding. Keep these three words in your mind. Telling, to tell something, to listen something, to understand something. This is the complete definition of business communication. The ideas or information you want to convey, the purpose of that communication is only to understand something. It must be clear and understandable. Now let's move to third definition. According to Fred Lewton, communication is the flow of material, information, perception, and understanding between various parts and members of organization. It means, like in any organization, if you want to become a successful businessman, if you want to become a successful student, if you want to become a successful parent, so you must have all sort of communication skills. You must have all sort of communication skills. Now, ideas, information, or the thing you want to convey, it must be understandable. Keep one thing in mind, it must be understandable. Now, for example, communication stands for, I'll tell you briefly, communication stands for word by word, like alphabetically, C stands for common language. Common language means if you want to speak in English, a person who's listening to you, it must be understandable for him. It means common language, because language is a mean of communication. Like it's a tool of communication. Language is a dress of a communicator. If you want to communicate ideas in English, if a person unable to understand, it means you are failure in your communication. So, common language, C for common language. Now, O, organizational interest. Communication must be in the interest of any organization. If it is not in the interest of any organization, means it's not helpful for businessmen, for any organization. You say that it's a failure one. So it must be in the interest or interest in the organization. So managing ideas, M for managing ideas, exchange ideas. In a survey, once I heard that 50,000 to 70,000 thought. We daily, you know, in our mind, we have 50,000 to 70,000 thought. But which thought we have to convey, it must be meaningful. There are so many thought in our mind. We don't want to convey all our thought to others. We want to convey only those thought which are meaningful, understandable, concrete, and clear. M, meaningful message. Message must be meaningful. Ideas or information you want to decode, encode, it must be meaningful message. It's not only written, it's not only oral, but it must be meaningful. Now, U for unity of thought. The thought must be united, collaborated, connected. It makes sense. And for noise. The first thing in communication, keep in mind, if you minimize barriers in communication, then you will understand it easily. Minimize the barriers. There are so many distraction, traffic sound, buzzing. You have to minimize the barrier. In order to understand it clearly, you have to minimize the barriers in communication. I for interest. Simply, communication must be interest for any businessman. It is in the interest in the organization. That's why they are using. For example, if a businessman want to advertise, so he might use different media of communication, newspaper, TV, radio. So all these modern technique, a businessman must have knowledge of all these modern technique to become successful in successful business career. So it is in the interest of businessman. Channels of communication, different networks of communication that we use, A, arouse interest. Communication required for businessmen, for parents, even we are communicating with student, we have to communicate in a way that it arouses interest in a student to learn, anxious to learn something. The way that we speak, they listen and understand. And the tone of language, it must be simple, concrete and clear. Tone must be simple one, because it is understandable. If we speak slowly, or if we speak, it's not clear, audible. It's failure in communication. So I means like input that we are receiving, giving, any organization is receiving or giving from superior to subordinate, from subordinate to superior in an organization. Organize ideas in thought. Thought must be organized, logically arranged, clear, and necessary for all. Necessary for all means communication is required in all sort of field, in any kind of business. Like American, they have made a fun and science of business communication. They are using modern technique, modern tools, and they are more advanced. They are successful because they have different sort of tools. Except that now, one thing that is very important, I want to say, D.G. Trackler says, what we remember, note one thing in mind, what we remember, 10% of what we read, the thing that we read daily, we remember only 10% what we read. It's a survey. Says 20% of what we hear. What we hear, we remember only 20%. 30% of what we see, the things that are behind us, we are seeing different things, 20% of what we see. 20% of what we hear, and 30% of what we see. And 50% of what we see and hear, combine both, 50% what we see and hear, jo dekhte hain aur sunte hain. 70% of what we say, the thing that we communicate, the thing that we convey, information, ideas, perception, feeling, thought, that we, what we say, we remember 70%. For example, I am communicating, I remember all these things. 70% to 80% I remember. 90% of what we act and experience, this is very important. 90% means approximately cover 90% of what we act and experience. When we are saying something, we are experiencing something, we are memorizing something. Because, you know, even when we are sleeping, our mind is working. Our mind is continuously thinking, viewing, seeing. So we can say that 90% of what we act and what we experience. Now let's move to the end point. Holy Quran says, we created man and taught him utterance. We cannot become silent. We are human being. We are social animal. We have to communicate. We have to speak. We have to understand. We have to think. We have to plan. We cannot become silent. It's inimical to man. It's inimical to man life. We cannot become silent. So according whether, you know, deciding whether language is informal, less formal or formal, it's not important. It must be clear, concrete, understandable. So we can say that in order to become a successful businessman in a personal life, communication is very important. Media, TV, VCR, fax, newspaper, all these are the, you know, channels, networks, media and forms of communication. These things are very necessary for us, because in order to be a successful businessman, in order to be a successful teacher, in order to be a successful student, in order to be a successful parents, we need to acquire all sort of communication skill. We must have all sort of communication skills. So I have tried to explain all these things in a simple way. So we can say another point, that human communication is a human and purposeful activity too. Like it's transmitted message from layman to chief devote. Like layman means a person who is not expert in a field. Chief devote means it's a literate person, like very thoughtful, creative. Communication is important for all. Even, you know, everyone want to communicate. Everyone want to understand. Everyone want to feel. Everyone want to plan. Everyone want to listen. Overall, I have explained different definitions in my first lecture. Now, dear student, I'll try my level best to explain you our next topic in my second lecture, importance of communication, or communication as the lifeblood of an organization. Keep watching. Thank you.